All right, guys. Derek says that you guys asked for a tech article on how to install a ragtop assembly. What I've done here is cleaned all the mechs up. I didn't tear them apart and get them all powder coated or anything like that. I just tore apart what needed to come apart. Painted some stuff, filled a couple holes, painted everything front and back so that it won't rust. Won't put rust on my new paint job. Also, I like to have a nice painted surface to glue my canvas to. I've got everything laid out here. Over here, I've got my headliner part of my ragtop and then the StayFast canvas. I've always used StayFast canvas, so I don't know what it's like to use the stock vinyl. Yeah, but the StayFast canvas works great, looks great, seals pretty good. Right here is also a rebuild kit from West Coast Metric to repair all your rollers and whatnot. Normally this is all you really need, are these four rollers, but occasionally one of these big ones is broke and it comes with the rivets. As you can see right here, these are where all four rollers go, two on this side, two on that side, and this one gets the big rollers. If these are broke on yours, you can buy those. They're rarely broke though. And I like to pad these on all cylinders because if you don't, and install the headliner, you're going to see all these teeth. You're going to be able to see all these screwed heads. And you can see where I've scraped off the factory stuff that was falling apart. And this is what I call trunk liner. That's what everybody calls it, the trunk liner. And we order it from Easton Brothers. It's relatively cheap. It's very thin and it hides all the imperfections like that. Here's my glue gun. I buy glue from the upholstery shops, about the 5 gallon barrels. This is just a cheap ass old, it's an HVLP siphon feed gun, but they're just cheap. You can get them at Harbor Freight or wherever. I never clean this gun, as you can see, buy the gun, so fill it up with glue and just let it roll. Stuff is contact adhesive, so you gotta put it on both pieces, let it dry a little bit, and then put everything together. I don't want to get glue all over the front of this bow, and it'd be almost impossible if I do something, so I'm gonna tape that. Because I don't know how many of you guys have had a car in an upholstery shop, but they get glue everywhere. I'm gonna tape this off so I don't get glue all over it. It takes less time to prep it in the first place than to clean it in the second place. Alright, you guys see how this is pretty much dry? It's barely sticking to me at all. That's pretty much ready to go together. I cut this way big because I'm going to stick it on there, glue it down, and I'm going to trim it exactly how I want. Got me a hole cut on this. Once you get these parts together, they stay together really well, so take your time and get it right on so you're not pulling it apart and having to re-glue it. Then take your razor blade, and basically you want to cut right against that finger right there.
Not the one with the band-aid on.
Kind of see where those screw heads are, but I'll be honest with you, I've seen headliners on ragtops where I can see the head of that screw, so this is going to make it a lot less. And now you won't be able to see the fingers. We trimmed it, and when we get the headliner in there and hammer it down, it'll be nice and soft and padded. So I'm done with that. I'll glue the canvas to the front and rear bow. Factory riveted these. I always glue them, I always have glued them, never had a problem gluing them. I guess I assume most people glue them nowadays. So let's get them on here. here. First mount the holes in this bow, the rear bow, and they go through the body, the bolts down on the back. You don't necessarily have to glue these, but if you don't glue them, put it up on the car, it's going to be flipped up like that, and it looks kind of stupid, like you got a wing on your Honda or something. So I glue them to prevent that. Okay, my experience is you need to get this in here first and see if you want to do any trimming. Like I said earlier, that glue, once you put that glue and everything, put it together, there's a bit to get apart. And as you can see, like these, this is laying up against that. So I'm going to trim that a little bit. Right here. I'm going to trim that right now before I start gluing. You can't see any part of this once the rag top's all together. I mean, take your time and do a good job, but it's not crazy crucial. Don't be nervous to work on your Volkswagen. And as you can see, that shit is tough. Get out my scissors here. All right, I got these trimmed out, so it should lay in there nicely after I get it all glued. Another thing I'm going to do, I'll show you guys before I glue it. The factory puts some padding right along this edge right here, and it's almost always missing, and that's part of what helps it seal. So I'm gonna go grab some of that, put that on real quick. Now you can put your rag top together without this. I've done it a bunch of times, but I think you'll be happier with the install if you put something back on there. I tried to save the factory stuff, but it's just missing too many chunks and it wouldn't look good. This is basically something you can get at Home Depot, any hardware store. 5/16 thick. You don't have to get this exact thing. I mean, it can be anything. You just want to get some padding up under the front of your rag top. Any kind of stick-on foam stuff. So that when you close it, there's some padding up there to help it seal. Alright guys, we've got our new pad on there, cut a little angle on it in the end, so it won't like have a ledge. I'll stick this in here, and I'm only going to glue this underside. That doesn't always work, but we're going to try to make it work today, because gluing both sides is a major pain. You want to make sure you get these all the way along at the same contour and angle of your header bow. I've seen lots of them where once they got them glued, they're all pulled over like this. And once again, that doesn't look good at all. So I'm going to spray some glue in here now. Only glue one side at a time, guys. I try to do both sides at once, as in the front and the back. I would recommend you glue both sides of this, left and right, sometimes. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start on the outside. I'm gonna try to get it really tight and centered up. And I'm gonna pull this all the way to the front. And I want that all the way over the front of that bow. Okay, and I haven't pushed it down at all yet. I'm still trying to make sure I got it in enough. It feels like I do. So I'm going to start right here in the middle. And I'm going to start pushing down, pushing the glue together. I'm going to start right here. I'm going to keep it nice and tight. Start pulling out. If anything, bend this down a little. You guys aren't going to believe how tight these new rag tops are. If you swear you're going to rip your material shutting it, break something. Right down tight. All these little bubbles out. Everything. And then before I go all the way around this corner, I'm going to come out here and make sure that's up against there. And I'm going to pull this tight, glue it down. That. Make sure all this is good and glued tight. Work it in here.
just get all that and see if you, keep working it, you can get it all glued down tight.
Okay, now I'm gonna start running this way. When you get this all the stuff installed, I don't like to glue the top side of this header bow because it is going to pull. When you get it shut, it's going to pull it back like that and get it straight. I don't like to glue it because if you glue that on and you don't get it in just the right spot, when it does pull it back, it's going to look funny. So I like to leave it loose if I can, but I'll be honest with you, I have had to glue them because they wouldn't stay on. This wasn't enough because these things are tight as all snot. So anyway, now we're going to glue the rear on. Most of the time the rear is not glued or anything, like you pull a factory one apart. But once again, I find that these new ones are so tight that if I don't glue them, same thing, it's going to pop that up when you shut it. So I don't like it. It looks bad. So I glue them. Once again, I'm going to try to only glue this bottom side. I'm going to try to make sure these are all like pulled over this way, because the car will push them back level, just pull them to the car. But you know, if you start it out like that, there's nothing is going to bring it back down for you once you get it on. So try to start out in this direction. So start out what I call the ball on your side of the table, and let the body just push it back flat. You get this in here where it goes. As you can see, they already have the cutouts and everything for you. That's where it goes. I'm gonna put some glue in there and glue it. And you know, if you guys don't have the glue gun at home, you can brush this glue on it too. Alright guys, we're gonna put these tacks in. You gotta leave these two small rails out to get everything in. I've already got my screws up here, so I better get them out. These rails, they look pretty good. I just polished them myself with like an automotive buffer and compound. I sanded them with 2000 grit and buffed them. Much about where you put these right now. All we're gonna do is get this canvas on here. These up here to start kind of stretching out the headliner. So this is where that rear bow bolts up. You see how these holes are slotted? I assure you, this damn thing is tight. It's gonna end up in the front, so you might as well just start it out there. These are 6mm. I always put a large washer on here, almost like a fender washer, just to make sure that if you over tighten this or something, you don't crack the thing on the outside. Not that you see it, your ragtop covers it. Another reason I keep saying about this stuff being tight, I think basically, this is a TMI made kit. I think basically they make everything just a couture tight, because a couture tight is much better than all saggy and loose. Start in the middle on these nuts and work your way out. And just get them finger tight for now until we get the bearing top closed. All right guys, we got our mechanisms in. We got all our nuts and washers on the bottom of our rear bow, only hand tight. And then I put in these rear rails to keep the mechanisms in. I should be done with installing rails. So I put those in, I'm done with that. We're gonna put this front header bow on and try to shut this rag top. Make sure it shuts. If it shuts, we'll pull it back off and do the headliner part. Okay guys, I pulled this header bow back a little bit, so we're not to fight with it when we're putting it together. These are the screws, and they're missing quite often to hold this stuff together. You're going to see all kinds of shit, old cars, to hold this together. These are the correct ones. You basically lower this header bow down and stick these through here, like so.
screw a little. All right, so we're gonna tighten the screw up. You don't have to get crazy over tightening it, especially right now since we're just mocking all this up.
That's a good shot.
Oh, see how nice and tight that is right there? Because of that foam. Yeah, see, that's beautiful. That's exactly what you want right there. Remember I was telling you guys about this flipping up? So I need to re-glue that center a little better. Yeah, it's all flipped up. Stupid. It's like a Honda with a wing. Alright, I'm gonna take this off and I'm gonna fix that back piece. Put it back on, latch it again. If it's nice and tight, I'm happy with it. Then I'll start doing the headliner part. Alright, so I was happy with the way the canvas fit. It was super tight, really good. So now I'm gonna start putting the headliner in. You guys remember I pad it? There's little fingers right here, just like on every other Volkswagen around the edges, like on this center of here, the opening. So I'm gonna tuck this, see there's a plastic strip in there. I'm gonna tuck the plastic strip in, hammer the fingers down. You wanna make sure you get the plastic strip tucked in like this. I'm gonna put it in there and just grab me a screwdriver or something to help tuck it down correctly. You wanna get you a clean hammer, not one of your greasy nasty ones. Tight here, and see where the handle goes. So I'm just gonna take my razor blade and cut only as big a hole as I need to here for this handle. Kind of mark it. Bring it down here. Cut it too big, the excretion isn't gonna hide the hole. So just big enough. Okay, and I'm gonna come back here behind it, shut it. Basically, this white strip here is what holds it up, makes it look tight inside the car. TMI cuts that for you. They want you to glue it over it, just like this. See, when it's shut, the canvas pushes this down. It makes it look nice and tight like that. I'm gonna go get my glue gun, I'm gonna glue this together. Guys, I glued these together. I'm gonna get this started here. Tight. Make sure you get it fairly even. See how tight that is. Okay, next thing I'm gonna do, just to be on the safe side, I'm gonna glue some in here. Hold this over. Make sure it's glued to two spots. Come off on the other side. Okay, TMI made these white things a little wide, and so it's going to make the headliner look a little saggy in the center. So I'm going to cut it right here. This razor blade's not too sharp. And then I'm going to glue this down out here like that and pull it tight when I do it to help keep it nice and taut in the center. No one likes a saggy ass headliner.
Okay, we got the front one done. The center bow here has screws that hold it up. So now what I'm going to do is the same thing on this one. See that? Just going to pull it down. I'm going to hold this over again, just like I did in the front. Also going to make sure this is still fairly snug to the outside, which it looks like it isn't quite.
Happy with the way you got that in there the first time? Don't be scared to pull it apart. It's contact adhesive, it'll stick right back together again. I didn't feel like I had it pulled out to the sides enough, so I redid this side. Coincidentally, I had to redo both sides. The last piece of the headliner is this, which folds up and goes in these holes here, which is actually probably the hardest part, pain in the ass. Sandwich this piece of the headliner between this one. So I'm gonna take, I'm gonna fold this over. So, pop a hole, that'll just plug right in. That's what I'm going to do right now. Sides in, kind of do the last few adjustments. You guys want to watch along. Once you get this inner headliner in, you got to put these screws in from the side. Get everything lined up.